took my breath away. Moving slowly through Westwood water.
Hey guys, welcome to Real and Raw with Raquel. This is Adeline. I'm finally getting to show her to you guys, and so we're gonna do a quick little tour, and then I'll tell you about how I got started, and maybe not why, but for sure how. So I'm sitting on my couch, and it's pretty stinking cool. I have this super awesome cushion, and I get to address my beautiful, you know, cushion. I can, I don't know, change it up if I want to. I love how much room is on this bench because I could totally have, you know, another room for another person. But it's also super great because if I am ready to do my work for the day, I can just grab my bag here in this super neat little cubby over here, and I can pour out all of my things and get to work. This is also my meal prep table. It's also my dinner table and my work table. So, pretty legit. I'm able to also take this all the way out and put it on the back side of my van if I wanted to have like an, I don't know, an outside barbecue on my patio, so to speak. Along with this one here. And I think that's probably why I don't actually have like a cushion to lean up against, because I have access to this. So if I want to put my computer here, I can have my drinks over here. It's kind of nifty. I have an outlet over here so I can have access to that. I don't have to, like, you know, find the things to do it over. This is my beautiful dresser. Go this way. Six cubbies, that's all I need, you guys. I have my work clothes, my t-shirts, my pants, my pajamas, chonies, and socks. I have socks, gloves, and hats, and my other workout clothes slash gym clothes. That's all I need, you guys. It's pretty cool. You're like, where do you put all your dirty laundry? Let me show you. In here, I love this. This is, it's magical. It's really simple to get in and out of. This is my dirty laundry, but I have extra storage. I can have my other shoes in here. I have a rain stick in here. If you need a bottle of water, like, let me just hook you up. Extra clothes that I'm not necessarily needing right now. And it's super convenient for me to get in and out of with this lid top. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. And it just, like, has a little lip in the bottom of it. So it sits in here really nice. And I have these little holes right here that I can stick my thumb in and maneuver it in the right spot. This is what I mean by putting a different color on it if I want to. And it just locks in, just like that. So, looking into my nightstand, this is my bed, beautiful bed. I get to sleep on it every night. It's so good, so comfortable. It's 4 feet by 6 feet. I can stretch out wholeheartedly from one end to the next. It's perfect for me. Two would be too crowded, but it's an option. but yeah, it's perfect. I stay plenty warm. I have a little wool blanket on top, a weighted blanket, and a sheet, and that's all I need. But looking over to my nightstand, it's pretty stinking personalized. I have all of my books. You'll find chocolate and all of the things, because that's my snack. Chocolate and gummy bears is where it's at. I'm able to put my things here, my books there, and extra goodies there. And I have this slide out, which is actually really neat. It's actually where I put my phone at night. Super convenient. I love using it. One more really cool feature. I got a hammock. So, you know, if I ever want to just read a book and hang out, I have a super cool feature to do that. So let's move on to my upper cabinets. These are super nifty and handy. They have a lip on them so things don't fall out when I'm driving. And I love that it's just open. I love open cabinets. It's how I roll. I have my little smoke alarm detector back here. And then there's just so much room for all the things. So this is all my personal Norwex inventory that I have to give to people to hand out. I have all my cups here. I think that's probably one of my favorite parts about living in 60 square feet is that I don't need a lot. I have 4 plates and 4 cups, or like bowls, but I genuinely, the only reason why I have a set of 4 is because I like to have people over. And over here I have personal Norwex stuff that I use for my kitchen, which we'll get to in just a second. I have a cute little Hustle and Heart painting that my sister-in-law gave me. And then all of my other personal Norwex items, my bath towels and my washcloths, and another cute little small secret cubby back here. So probably one of my best features, or most used features that I have, is my light. And so I'm gonna shut one of these off, because this is like my kitchen light. And this is my, I can dim it light. And I love this feature, and I'm so, so thankful for it, because I like night lights, and so this is just, it's perfect. So, super great. I have a cute little panel over here that's super handy, and I use it every single day. So let's welcome you to my humble abode in my kitchen. And I think the best part about my kitchen is, well, for me personally, I can stand up in my kitchen. And so when I meal prep on Sundays, like I showed you, I pull out that table and I can do all of the things. Okay, I have a 4 stove burner and an oven, and all runs off of propane. I have a skillet and my pot, and I cook all of the things from it. I love, love, love it. Super unique with my kitchen sink. I'll call me the princess of everything, because I wanted a kitchen sink that I would actually use. And so we got a super high sink faucet and a really big deep sink, so that way I wasn't like overwhelmed or overcrowded with the amount of dishes that I use when I meal prep or just in general eat food. And so it was actually able for me to use, and like, I don't know, I'd actually want to use it. So I love this. It's actually a pretty neat feature. I can slide this in here just really easily, and it sits there. I can also keep it here if I need an additional flat space. But again, this makes my kitchen so much bigger when I have this pull out. So really, it's just super unique and convenient, and I love, love, love it. So you can see that I have all my produce sitting on my counter. I have lots of space. My knives are up on a little magnet board. And in my upper cabinets, I have my coffee or chai tea mugs, my wash, rinse, and repeat sign. And this is where I have my like quick glass of water in the morning. And all of my toiletries are right here, so I can brush my teeth in my sink. And it's not weird. So this is almost, I want to call it a man cave, but it's not. It's just a really big, I don't even know. It's just, it's awesome. So I'm gonna pull these out. This is, when I'm driving, I turn these around. This is actually my pantry. I turn them around just so that nothing falls out. And then when I'm plugged in and stationary for the night, I just turn them back around. And so I have all things food in here. Girl, tell me to stop going shopping, but I guess apparently I have a problem. But it's so good. So, literally, I have like a snack bag and then like a dinner side of my this little tote. All of my snacks. And I don't know how well it is, but literally like I have my pantry in here and more bulk items and more bulk items. And then all things books. I have a library in here, and it just keeps going. It's so big. So it goes all the way this way over my cab, all the way back, and it's carpeted beautifully, and everything just is so nice. Oh, I also keep more produce back here because I eat all things produce. And then it goes back all the way on this side too. So it's just huge. It's so, like, I don't know, I don't think I could not have one of these. Like, it is just a huge blessing, and I love it. So, super, super awesome. So yeah, this is my life now in a van. And let's talk about how I got started. So, crazy story, but I had this idea, like, would it be cool to live in a van and like travel? And I was like, yeah, why not? Got nothing to lose, right? And so I kind of was like, okay, did some like research and knew that I wanted a van. I knew that I wanted a high top so I could stand up in it. And I wanted it already gutted out. I didn't want to do like extra work. And so that's what I knew. And so I kind of looked for a couple of months and I couldn't find what I was looking for. So I kind of put it on the back burner and I just kept saving up money. What happened in September, on a Friday, I got a call from my godfather and he's like, hey, check out this van. And it was the exact price I wanted. It was 3 hours away by a older couple who had, it was already cleaned out and it had a wheelchair lift in it. But it was the exact price I wanted. So I called them immediately and I was like, you guys, don't sell this out from underneath me. I have cash. I will be there on Saturday. Like, I will be there. They're like, okay, honey. And so I show up and it's everything I wanted. I crammed my brother, he's like 6 foot tall, in my small Subaru Legacy. And I was like, you're coming with me. He comes and he looks it over for me. He looks at everything and he's like, it's up to you. Do you want to buy this? And I'm like, yes, I'm driving it home. And so we picked it up and it was everything I wanted. Fast forward to probably a month later, I kind of sat on it for a month, not really sure like that I just bought a van. And I took it over to my godfather's house and me and my buddy stripped it to metal. And I was like, okay, cool. That wasn't too bad. It was a lot of work, a lot of things I pulled out of there. But what happened the next day was I had a meltdown because I didn't know how to put batteries in. I didn't know how to build furniture. I didn't know how to put all the wires and the electricity in. And so by word of mouth, heard about Turner Tiny Homes. And I was like, they build tiny homes for a living. How much different is it than a van? So I called them and I left a message and I said, hey guys, you don't know me, but I heard about you through a friend. And if you could just call me back so I could explain to you my vision, I would really appreciate it. Y'all, they called me back. I was afraid they weren't going to because I was just nervous about who converts a van into a home. And so I got to spend over like half hour with Kyle talking to him about my vision, and I generally was like, I just want you to do the electrical and maybe build it up a little bit. And it ended up turning into, hey, do you want to just do the whole thing? And he agreed. He agreed to everything. Kyle and Jen helped me pick out some things, helped me like direct me in the right decision for like the colors and like how things are gonna look good, and I still am on cloud nine that this is my home. It's like it's my dream come true, and genuinely I couldn't ask for anything better. The work is done really well. It's insulated, it is nice and pretty for me, and it's perfect. So long story short, this is Adeline. So, living in the van, not gonna lie, I was super nervous at first. Like, I remember I had moved in and put all the things in, right? But I'm a busy person and so I'm never home. But the first night I was actually like, this is officially my life now. I came into the van, and it was clean. And my bed was made. And I was a little nervous, like, this is your life now, Raquel. But no, I love it. I love that I don't need a lot. I love that my bed fits me. I love how simple things are. I only have what I need in here. And I think for me and my personality, that works really well. And so I just enjoy it all. And it's pretty well suited for me because I can stand up in here, I can sleep in my bed. Like, if it was any other person, they probably wouldn't be able to, like, make it work. But, with me, I'm able to. It's quite built to my size, which is really cool. But, yeah, the it's not hard. It's not hard to do your dishes with cold water. It's not hard to go to the gym and shower. It's, these things aren't hard, and they're already a part of my life. And so, for me and my lifestyle, it's quite perfect. And what I'm learning that I actually am enjoying more is that I actually enjoy cooking. I hate going to the grocery store, but not anymore. I don't know. It's different. So all things good when it comes to me and my van.